Ambassador Dr. Dino Patijalal gave his first-hand insights on President Obama's much-anticipated visit to Indonesia during a luncheon with Asia Society Corporate members on Monday, November 15, 2010. Ambassador reiterated the visit of President Obama as a historic one amidst uncertainty due to Merapi volcanic ashes. The visit highlighted the strong commitment between the two leaders to expand and deepen bilateral relation between the two countries.
We had very historic and productive bilateral visit.
During the bilateral meeting, a rich and substantive discussion was held between the two leaders, ranging from bilateral to regional and global issues. The meeting generated a joint declaration on comprehensive partnership. The ambassador emphasized that Indonesia and the United States is now in the new era of partnership, where there are broader scopes of cooperation in various issues. On November 15, 2010, the Embassy of the Republic of Indonesia hosts a reception for members of the Washington Performing Arts Society, or WPAS. The society was founded in 1965, focused on art, cultures, and education for young children. Throughout the years, the Indonesian Embassy and the WPAS has been in a close cooperation, especially in the Embassy Adoption Program, in which every year the embassy adopts one school in Washington, D.C. area. During the program, the embassy shares Indonesian arts and cultures to the students. The reception featured a remark from Mr. Douglas Wheeler, a president emeritus of the WPAS, and a remark from Ambassador Dino Patijalal. In his remarks, Ambassador Jalal praised the works and contribution of the WPAS in supporting cultural events and encouraging people to know other cultures and traditions.
President Obama came to Indonesia, and notwithstanding all the domestic politics that was going on here, President Obama was a rock star in Indonesia.
Present for you and your wife. Being in the nonprofit world means so much. Very sincere thanks.
On the special night, the embassy presented a traditional dance called Renggong Manis that enchanted the audience. Concluded the event that night, the WPAS introduced a young talented singer, Anis Murillo, a 13-year-old, who has an angelic voice, singing Amazing Grace and Over the Rainbow. On November 16, 2010, after arriving from Jakarta for President Obama's visit, Ambassador Dino Patijalal hosts a town hall meeting with Indonesian society at the ambassador's residence. The ambassador shared his account and insights on President Obama's visit and several other issues, including the latest updates from Mentawai, Wasior, and Merapi natural disaster. The topic of Obama's visit undeniably was the spotlight of the night. Ambassador Dino described the visit as a great success for Indonesia and America. The visit positively enhanced the diplomatic relation between two countries into a more constructive partnership amidst global challenges. During his visit, Obama also delivered a comprehensive speech on Indonesia, which was broadcasted live throughout the world.
For a president to do that to Indonesia, then I don't think it will be repeated again. You know, that moment when the whole world focused on Indonesia to listen by a speech about Indonesia, and such a glowing positive speech.
During the meeting, Ambassador also engaged a lively discussion with the community on several other issues, such as dual citizenship, Indonesian labor, the effort to increase Indonesian labor to United States, and a discussion on how to better organize fundraising to generate aid for the natural disaster victims in Mentawai, Wasio, and Merapi. On 22nd November 2010, the Embassy of the Republic of Indonesia in Washington, D.C. hosts a dinner reception for participants of the Leadership Consultation on Faith, Health, and Development in cooperation with Center for Interfaith Action for Global Poverty, or CIVA. The reception is a part of 2 days event aimed to create a strategic framework to increase the scale and impact of multi-religious cooperation on global health and development. Around 85 leaders and stakeholders from the religious and public sectors attended this inspirational dinner. The dinner featured a speech from Indonesian Ambassador Dr. Dino Patijalal. In his speech, the ambassador addressed the importance of religious harmony and the important role of religious leaders in promoting, materializing, and strengthening the harmony. Ambassador Jalal assured that in this 21st century, it is finally possible for us to reach a total confluence among civilizations.
It is possible for us to reach that condition of confluence among civilizations, one condition that has been elusive in the previous centuries. And your work is one of the giant steps that we can take to make that a reality. Thank you very much.
For those who want to seek information on consular and visa, may visit our website at www.embassyofindonesia.org. That's all for our updated news. Thank you for watching.